main point of the article is it is about capacity and capacity management and the selling of capacity as an economic phenomenon for a manufacturing company to optimize profitability. There's a saying that's going around in manufacturing these days, goes something like this: what do we make? What do we sell? Capacity. What do we make? Money. That's sort of an antidote to the traditional manufacturing answer to that question, which would be we sell widgets and we make parts with which to assemble widgets. What we're seeing now is hopefully more focus on the fixed cost of capacity as the determinant of profit and the ability or the need to utilize that capacity to a greater extent with which to make money. I've made this point before. The obvious analogy is an airplane. An airplane that gets into the air with empty seats is an example of underutilized capacity. Bob Crandall, who was the CEO of American Airlines and was formerly the CFO of American Airlines, used to say that when he bought an airplane, he made a billion-dollar bet that he could fill it up. Well, that's the same phenomenon as the person who builds a factory with all those bricks and mortar and pieces of equipment. They're making a bet that they can fill it up and utilize the capacity. So now airline companies pay attention to getting the seats filled. Manufacturing companies need now to think about getting the capacity utilized and have the factory completely filled. Well, I think, you know, the obvious issue is for general management, but CFOs facilitate what general management people do by presenting data in a manner that keeps them focused on that which makes the money for the company. General management people, marketing people, manufacturing people are so caught up in the day-to-day that the larger picture of seeing how the capacity is being used in this case is happening. Capacity utilization numbers typically not included in financial reporting packages. The numbers are there. They're not typically in the accounting system, but they are in the modern ERP system. But they can be found there. And I think the point about this is the financial executive has to be presenting that kind of data so that manufacturing and general management people are constantly aware of how much capacity they're selling. And how much they're not selling. Again, I'm sure that somebody in American Airlines is looking at the number of the capacity utilization of planes on a day-to-day or week-to-week basis to make sure that planes are filled up. Well, we've talked about this before, and you know, I've written some articles in CFO Studio magazine about it, in fact. And we hear a lot about manufacturing coming back, and there's the problem with that sort of thinking is that it assumes that manufacturing went someplace, and it really didn't. We hear a lot about sneakers being made in Malaysia and other things being made abroad, but manufacturing in this country continues to grow. The Index of Industrial Production, which is published by the Federal Reserve System, shows that manufacturing numbers, production numbers, continue to grow. Now, they go up and down. In 2008, they didn't go up, but they actually went down. But if you draw a least squares line through them, a regression line through those data, those up and down data, you will find that manufacturing continues to grow. I think the bigger problem, and people are concerned about this, and rightfully so, is about jobs. The feeling that if manufacturing comes back, there'll be all sorts of manufacturing jobs, or if there's more manufacturing. That's probably not going to happen. Manufacturing jobs are not going to grow the way they used to grow, even with greater growth in manufacturing. Automation has taken its toll on those jobs, and they're not likely to come back. The jobs that will happen as a result of more manufacturing, if we can get the industry to grow like it once grew, will be the ancillary jobs that come about as the result of greater manufacturing activity and more goods being produced. So, for example, when more goods are produced, more factories are needed. When more factories are needed, factories need to be built on property, which is called real estate. Real estate strategies people who sponsor CFO Studio are certainly well acquainted with that. So make a product, you have to store a product in a building, then you have to insure the building, then you have to insure the product, then you have to distribute the product, then you have to finance the product. So there are all sorts of activities that start to happen as a result of manufacturing. So if manufacturing gets growing at a rate greater than the GDP, what will happen is jobs will start to happen in those ancillary sectors. And that's the real value of manufacturing in the 21st century. In the 20th century, it was about manufacturing jobs. There were loads of them around. You saw people lined up at factory gates when the shift changed. We're never going to see that again.
Well,
the article is about capacity management. But it's also about throughput accounting, which is really the 21st century management accounting that presents numbers in a way that focuses on the utilization of the capacity and starts to look at incremental gross margin in a different way. It puts it in the context of the constraint resource in a factory so that more money is made. It's based on the concepts of constraint management as articulated by Ellie Goldratt in his book, The Goal. I'd hope that our CFO readers of the magazine and the website will take a look at this and start to embrace this new concept. I didn't invent it. I write about it, but it took a while for me to understand it, and I hope the readers of the magazine will take that time to understand it and start to see it as a useful tool in running their businesses.